If you don't want to be dependent on any additional tools to test your components. In the end, your React components are just JavaScript functions, so we can just invoke them. In this demo, we will test our button components that we used in our last video. So remember, React components are just functions returning an object that represents your element. So if you remember, this is our button. We render a text when we don't have an icon passed, and we don't have the icon passed as a prop, then we just render an image. So let's how we can test that. So first we need to just import your button itself, and then let's add our blocks of descriptions as we did before. So describe when icon prop not passed. So what we are expecting, it should render text, and we know it will be the text button exactly. Okay, and so how we can test that? So what we can do, we'll just import our component and don't pass it the prop itself. So we'll say const, for example, my components. You can call it anything you want, const my component, and to be equal to my button, but without any props passed. So just remove the opening tag and to be executed as a function, and we are not passing anything. So here we have icon and we have data test ID. At this point we don't need both of them, so we just keep it like this. Okay, now we say expect, we'll make our assertion, what we are expecting. Expect that my component, so we said return an object, right? So it have something called props, and you can see here my Visual Studio Code is helping me, dot props, dot children. I want it to be equal to button. Save, my test will run. Oh, here should be text. And it fails. Let's see what's happened. So if you could not destruct property icon of undefined as it is undefined. So what we can do, I'll just pass here an object, empty one, save, and it passed. Nice, so it find my text. So see here, we didn't use any other library. All what we have done is just call my component as a function and don't pass any prop. The downside for this, as you can see, we are accessing our component as an object, and we are going like a true nested way to access our text. Let's say, for example, if sometime someone came here, and instead of having just button, but they have actually a span and close and have button in there, my test will fail. There you see. So that's the problem we said in our first overview, that our test should be smart, the way that it tests only what we need. So for example, I know my components need to render text button. It doesn't matter where it rendered. Is it a span? Is it a p tag? Or is it without a span? But I want it just render from your button. But for a simple scenario here, because I only add a span, it broke. So let's also remove this now and test the other scenario where it is having an icon. So you see also how we are passing that as a prop. So here, when icon prop is passed, should render an image. So again here we're just passing icon, and that will be true. and now we'll say it should be. So we can access it by type. So I'll say my comment.type, it should be an image tag. Save and fails. And let's see why. So we received button, and that's because the first level. I'm on the second level. So what I will do, I will say dot props dot children dot prop dot type. Oh no, I go backward and say dot type. Save. And that passed. Okay, so basically I'm saying access my component, its props, I want the children. So this is a children of my component, and in that children I want the type to be matching an image tag. Let's say now you want really to prove that really your tests are working and really what you have done, it's doing its job. So we can, for example, say let's not a developer came and break your component. And here what they did, instead of doing this, we'll just do opposite. When icon is not passed and return image, otherwise put a button. So we know that's not what the comment should be doing, but let's say someone by mistake came and did this. We hit save and we should see all our tests failing, at least in the button index, not in the app.test. So you can see here, both our tests are failing. So our test is doing really what it's supposed to do.